Today we're going to talk about character and inventory restoration, the appreciation pack, and the player base, and we're going to start right now. What's up, guys? Reckless here, and welcome back to another video. Today, we have a lot of news to go over when it comes to Outriders. And if you guys want to see more Outriders content in the form of class builds, legendary farming, official and fan-made lore, news, updates, and more, be sure to subscribe down below and turn on notifications so you never miss out on any video. Okay, so it's been 24 hours since the character and inventory restoration for Outriders has begun. Yesterday night, on the official Outriders Twitter page, they released a tweet giving all of the juicy details on the character restoration with a link to their Reddit post. I'll summarize it now, but if you want to read the entire patch notes, then I will put them in the description box below. This first part only applies to Group A. Group A characters are those characters who encountered a wipe and are no longer able to log in at this point in time. And then you encounter a couldn't connect to server error. Group A restoration. All items, regardless of rarity, that were equipped at the time of your inventory wipe will be restored. All legendary items that were in your inventory. For non-legendary items, 20 previously acquired items that were in your inventory with first prioritization based on rarity, and this is descending from epic rarity, and second prioritization based on date acquired. All fully completed accolades will be restored if you previously reached the final tier of said accolade. Interim tiers and progress towards any tier of an accolade cannot be recovered. So, what this means is that restoration for Group A has already begun and for some people is still kind of underway. I started to get my stuff yesterday after closing the game and going back into it. Unfortunately, I had already made a second trickster who happened to be even stronger than my first one in only 2 days. Shout out to all of my friends who painfully experienced the horror of bringing a new character into expeditions. I love you guys for it. So, how do you know if you actually got a god roll item? Well, all of the legendary weapons are actually on your other characters that weren't affected by a wipe at a firepower of 99,400, or if they are not level 50, they can be upgraded to have that number of firepower. If I'm correct, sidearms are at 79,500 and all legendary armor drops at 11,300. Now, let's get into restoration for Group B and C. Group B players are those players who lost items but were able to continue playing. Group C players are those players who were not affected by an inventory wipe or had any lost items. Those people get up to 20 legendary items that were in your inventory that you may have had previously lost to a bug, and that's specifically for Group B, or sold to a vendor, which is Group B and C. Dismantled items will not be restored, as PCF's analytics are not able to conclusively prove that they were not lost to a bug. So, everyone gets something, whether you lost something in your inventory or not. However, the appreciation pack will be a little while after all of the groups, A through C, have been taken care of. I do, however, wish that they told us how they plan to go about getting our God Rolls legendaries. Had we known, I'm pretty sure a lot of us would have a god roll weapon we could have liked. I don't know about you, but I am probably one of the many people in this game that have one of the strongest migraines in this game. Pun intended. With all that said, what does this mean for the player base though? Now that people are getting all of their characters and their gear back, it seems like the player base will increase once again. Unfortunately, the character and inventory wipe did leave a mark on a lot of people, and it seems like we may not see the same player base numbers as we did on the game's first week of its release. But any increase is still a positive one. What I don't understand is how a few days ago, Apex Legends had an inventory wipe across the board and was able to fix it within a few hours. But it took Outriders several weeks to fix their inventory wipe, and not everyone was affected. Now, I do understand that, yes, they do have different publishers, but I will say this. The inventory wipe issue should have been resolved within 48 hours of it actually happening. Just saying. Either way, how are you guys liking the fixes for the character in inventory wipes? And if you were affected, will you be coming back to the game or not? Let me know down in the comment section below. And that, my friends, brings us to the end of the video. If you need a place to play Outriders, come join the Everything Outriders Discord. Every platform is welcome. You can make new friends, get help with expeditions like Challenge Tier 14, 15, and Eye of the Storm, get detailed information such as data mines, patch notes, lore, and a look at all of the legendaries in the game as well. We are well over 265 members, and it is growing every day, so come and join us. A link to the Discord will be in the description box below, and I will see you guys in the next one. Hey, you, watch these videos too. I know you like them. Go. Go.